Hello everyone, myself Professor M.S. Kuite, Assistant Professor of Department of Agricultural Entomology, KKWA College of Agriculture, Nasik. Today I am going to deliver the lecture of course number NTO243, that is Pest of Horticulture Crops and Their Management. So in this lecture, we are going to learn about the pest of mango. So these are the different pests of mango. First one is mango stem borer, then second one is mango fruit fly, then mango stone weevil, mango hoppers, mealybugs of mango, thrips of mango, then sludge caterpillar, mango gall midge, and last one is shoot borer of a mango. So first and major pest of mango is mango stem borer. It belongs to family Cerambycidae and order is Coleoptera. So these are the two different species of the mango stem borer which attacks on the stem of a mango tree. So first one is Batocera rufomaculata and second one is Batocera rubus. So this is the grubs and pupa of mango stem borer. So next point is life history or life cycle and mark of identification of the pest. So the oviposition means the site of egg laying under the loose bark, and the larva is a podous type and have strong jaws. And then most damage is caused by the larva. Pupation takes place inside the stem and adult development complete in 60 to 100 days. The adults chew on a green growing tips and on the bark of the twigs, and the number of generation of a mango stem borer is 1 per year. The next point is nature of damage. How this pest damage to the stem of mango tree. On hatching, the grubs make a zigzag burrows beneath the bark and tunnel into the trunks or a main stem. Moving upward, feeding on the vascular tissues, interruption of nutrient and water transport on the tissues. After that, due to the feeding, drying of terminal shoot in early stage and the mass of frost or the refuse gets accumulated beneath the bark, or sometimes sap and masses of a frost may be seen exuding from the bore hole, and the infestation may lead to its losses and even to the death of mango trees. So this is the nature of damage. You can see the grubs feeding inside the stem of mango tree. Then this is also damaging symptoms by this pest. Then next point is management practices. Firstly, remove and destroy the dead and severely affected branches of the tree. Then locate the grubs, remove and kill them. Use neem-based biopesticide inside the hole, or also use the lantana camera leaf extract 5%. If infestation are severe, then apply the copper oxychloride paste on the trunk of the trees. Then we can also apply the carbofuran 3g 5 gram per hole and plug this hole with the mud, and also we can use the sulfos tablet per hole. Then inject the borer solution and then remove the frost near the hole on a main stem and inject 4 ml of methyl parathion. So these are the management practices. So in these both image we can see the application of copper oxychloride paste on the tree trunk of the mango trees. Then second important pest of mango is mango fruit fly. The scientific name of mango fruit fly is Batrocera dorsalis, and it belongs to family Trapetidae and order is Diptera. The important point is this pest having the international importance or quarantine pest, and the mango fruit fly also called as oriental fly or the golden fly. Then life history. eggs deposited under the rind of the fruit, and the larva is yellowish or porous maggots. Maggots means nothing but the legless larva. Pupation takes place inside the soil, and the pupa is barrel shaped. So here we can see the eggs of fruit fly and the larva or the maggots. This is also the egg laying of the fruit fly under the rind of the fruit. The nature of damage of fruit fly. Adult female flies cause punctures in the fruits for oviposition. After hatching from the eggs, maggots bore into the semi-ripened fruits with decayed spots and feed on the pulp. Later on, a brownish rotten patch makes its appearance on the surface of the attacked mango fruits with the characteristic oozing of fluid after the maggots have eaten the pulp. After that, infested fruits start rotting and the fruit eventually drops down when the maggots come out and enter the soil for pupation. So these are the nature of damage by the fruit fly. Then next point is control measure or the management practices. Firstly, orchard sanitations means the daily removal and destruction of the fallen affected fruits and dispose them by dumping in a pit. Also provide the summer ploughing to expose the pupa. If the trees are few, bagging the fruits with the cloth or paper bags can be tried for the protection. Then monitor the activity of fruit fly population in orchards by using the methyl eugenol traps, are also called as rakshak trap. Then the spread of this destructive pest can be prevented only by applying the strict quarantine measures. Then biological control. We can release the natural enemies of this pest like Opius compensatus and Spalangia philippines. So these are the biological control agent for the fruit fly. Then we can also apply the spray bait. Then spraying the trees and adjoining hedges with 0.1% carbaryl or also 0.05% malathion. Also use of chemotropic oils and the chemical. So these are the control measure for management of the fruit fly of mango. Then third major pest of mango is mango stone weevil, or also called as mango nut weevil. The scientific name of this pest is Sternocetus mangiferi, and it belongs to family Curculionidae and order is Coleoptera. The host plant of this pest is only mango, means it is the monophagous pest. Then life cycle. Eggs deposited in the skin of ripening fruit, means in epicarp, and the pupation takes place inside the stone or the nut. The life cycle completed in 40 to 50 days and only one generation in a year, and the adult weevil remains inactive from July to August onwards and hiding in the soil or underneath the bark or hidden in the cracks and crevices on the trunk of a trees until the next season. So this is the larva, pupa and adult of the stone weevil. Then next point is nature of damage. Oviposition injures on marble sized fruits, then grubs bore through the pulp enter into the stone and passes its entire life inside the stone. After that, adult feed on the pulp and find its way out of ripe fruit, and as a result of feeding, the discoloration of a pulp adjacent to the stone and larval excreta is often seen when the infested mangoes are cut. There is no external sign of infestation on a fruit and fruit dropping at the marble stage. So these are the nature of damage of the mango stone weevil. This is also damaging symptoms by this paste. Then management practices. Spraying the trunks with a kerosene oil emulsion after harvest to kill the adults. Then destruction of affected fruits. Maintain the hygiene in a storage place. Also digging of soil to expose the hibernating weevil. Then spraying on young fruits with 0.1% malathion. Then drenching or spray of either carbaryl 0.2%. So these are the different management practices for control of mango stone weevil. Then next major pest of mango is mango hoppers. So these are the three different species which is attacks on the mango tree. First one is Ambrotodus atkinsoni. It belongs to family Cicadellidae. Then second species is Idioscopus clypellis. It is also belongs to family Cicadellidae. And third species of mango hopper is Idioscopus neoparsus, and it belongs to family Jacidae. So these three different species of mango hoppers, and it belongs to order Hemiptera. So this is the three species images. First one is Ambrotodus atkinsoni, second one is Idioscopus clypellis, third one is Idioscopus neoparsus. Then next point is life cycle. How the paste completes its life cycle. The eggs deposited or laid in the tissues of flowers and midribs of the young leaves. Then nymphal period is 80 to 13 days and total life cycle completed in 12 to 29 days. Then adult hibernates under the bark of the trunk. Then this paste is active during the mainly flowering season. So these are the nymphs and adult hibernates under the bark of a trunk. Then next point is nature of damage. The damaging stage of this paste is nymph and adult. So the both nymphs and adult suck the cell sap from the young leaves, tender shoots and flower, due to which flower buds wither and die off. The damage is more pronounced in flowering season. Then premature dropping of flowers and fruits occurs. Also, this paste excretes the honeydew, which encourages the development of black sooty mold. And as a result of feeding, the upper surface of leaves, flowers and shoots become a black, which affect the fruit setting. So this is the nature of damage of the mango hoppers. Then control measure or management practices. So firstly, avoid the close planting as the incidence very severe in overcrowded orchards. Then orchard must be kept clean by plowing and removal of the weeds. Then when we go through the chemical control, you can spray 2 rounds of acephate 75 SP at the rate of 1 gram per liter. Then first spray at the time of panicle emergence and second spray 2 weeks after the first spray. Then can use the wettable sulfur 2 gram per liter. Then the mixture of toxaphene with the sulfur has been reported to effective against the paste. We can also use a neem oil 5 ml per liter of water can be mixed with any insecticide. Then spray 3% neem oil or neem seed kernel extract powder 5%. So these are the management practices for the control of mango hoppers. Then next sucking pest of the mango is mealybugs. The scientific name of mealybug is Rosica mangiferi, and it belongs to family Pseudococcidae and order Hemiptera. It is also monophagous pest of mango. Means the host plant is only mango. The oviposition or the site of egg laying of the mealybug under the bark, and the eggs are deposited in the soil. So during April, May, hatch in December to January. Male completes his life cycle in 60 to 119 days and female complete its life cycle in 77 to 135 days. Female wingless, while male have a brownish black wings in case of mealybugs. Then next point is nature of damage. Presence of pinkish nymphs and adult mealybugs on a fruit and fruit stalk. The nymphs and adult females suck the cell sap from flowers, developing fruits and shoots. It also excretes the honeydew on which sooty mold develops, affecting adversely on photosynthesis. Drying of leaves and inflorescence occurs. The flowers and developing fruits drop off. So these are the damaging symptoms by the mealybugs. This is also damaging symptoms. The next point is control measure. Firstly, plowing below the tree to expose the eggs. Then soil application of 2% methyl parathion dust to kill newly emerged nymphs. Also use the sticky bands to prevent the climbing on trees. Then spray with 0.04% monocrotophos or also spray with verticillium lecanii 0.2%. Use of predator like Cryptolemus montrosauri. Then in case the nymphs climb up the tree, there should be control at the earliest by spraying carbaryl 0.2%. So these are the management practices for the control of this pest. Then last pest of the mango is mango gall midge. The scientific name of this pest is Rheosoma mangiferi. It belongs to family Cecidomyidae and order is Diptera. The host plant is the only known host of mango gall midge is mango. Then life cycle. The female lays eggs singly into the tissue of the young leaves or also on the under surface, leaving a small reddish spot. Means the oviposition of this pest into the tissue of young leaves or on the under surface. Then the mature larva drop down into the soil for pupation. So the pupation or the site of pupation of this pest in the soil. Then mango leaf gall midge is spread by wind currents and movement of infested plant material. So these are the life cycle and there are the 3 to 4 overlapping generation of this pest. Then nature of damage. Its feeding induces the formation of small galls which look like pimples on the leaves. So we can see in this image the formation of small galls, or it look like the pimples on the leaves. The larva means the maggots bore inside the leaf tissues and feed within, resulting in the formation of small red wart like galls on the leaves. Gall formation begins within 7 days. Heavily gall leaves curl up and drop up prematurely, causing dieback of whole branches in susceptible cultivars. After, the gall leaves remaining on the trees are known to provide reservoirs of the anthracnose inoculums. Small emergent holes may be detected where larvae leave the gall through as they go to the soil for pupation. These holes allow for secondary fungal infection as they create entry points into the plant tissues. So these are the nature of damage of this pest. Then management. Collection and destruction of affected leaves. Then maintenance of field hygiene or sanitation. Then proper weed control. Then plowing of orchards to expose the pupating and deposing larvae to sun heat, which kills them. Then also we can use the use of sticky traps to catch the flies and spray with dimethoate 30 EC or also spray with methyl dimethon. So these are the management practices.